that good. Good luck. And if you're going to pass it on...
Every day, we rely on the well operation of many critical infrastructures for our everyday activities, like watching TV or making dinner. Examples are the production and distribution of power, gas and oil, or the cleaning and distribution of water. These infrastructures are critical for the well-being of the society and the economy.
Such infrastructures are controlled by SCADA networks, where SCADA stands for Supervisory Control and Data Analysis. In such networks, sensors continuously measure, for example, the temperature and the pressure of the water. The measured data is then forwarded to the controller. And the controller sends, for example, open and close commands to valves and start-stop commands to pumps. Unfortunately, these systems are exposed to a variety of attacks.
Physical attacks include the contamination of fluid with chemicals or damage to pipes, where cyber attacks include fooling sensors to propagate faulty measurements or to change the visual display at the operator's computer.
If the water supply breaks down, we cannot shower or water the plants. But also, production at big facilities has to stop because their cooling systems no longer work. If the power supply breaks down, the productivity of the country is substantially reduced. Cooling of perishable foods is no longer guaranteed. Hospitals have to rely on the well operation of backup power generators to ensure the care of their patients. Our goal at DAX is to make critical infrastructures more reliable. So on the one hand, we build intrusion detection systems that can detect attacks in a timely manner, so that appropriate countermeasures can be taken. This is Raphael's area of research.
The topic of my research is intrusion detection in SCADA networks. So we're talking about networks that run in big installations like this one here. In traditional IT networks, the traffic is too unpredictable because it's mainly generated by humans. SCADA networks, the traffic, it's mostly generated by machines like sensors and actuators. So we believe the traffic in SCADA, it's more regular, more predictable. We believe we can make models to describe it and then detect anomalies as violation to these models. To build these models, we use two sources of information. The first one is a study of SCADA protocol. And the second one is data capture in real installations, like this one.
However, no intrusion detection system will be able to detect every attack. So our second line of research is to make systems more reliable and dependable, even in the presence of failures and attacks. This is Stefan's area of research.
My goal in this project is to model critical infrastructures like this electricity plant and to look at these models in various situations.
Like, what if a valve fails? What if an attacker attacks the system? And how does it operate in normal situations?
The advantage of using models like this is that we can actually study the impact of an event without hampering the productivity. So we can actually see, okay, if I shut this valve off, what happens to the system without having to influence the production to the consumer. In these models, I can also look at what the influence of using a specific type of repair order has on the recovery time and on the availability of the system. So for instance, this station right here, it fails. How long does it take for the consumer to be having their gas back? Another thing we also look at with these models is how does the order in which repairs are done influence the time needed for recovering after a given event.
However, modeling these systems is very challenging, as these systems are very complex and have many interdependencies. Therefore, in my study, I separate the physical system from
the SCADA network. And hopefully, in the end, we can combine those two models into one big model.
When DAX is working on critical infrastructures, their constant supply is almost guaranteed. Yes. And you never miss your favorite TV show.
Are you ready for DAX? amare, ma così non c'è niente da fare.